What is up, dudes? Chuck here. Welcome back to the channel. Today is an exciting day. It is step one of an exciting mod we're going to do to the WRX STI. If you follow me on Instagram or if you read the title of this video, we're going to be getting a new wheel and tire combination for the STI. Super exciting. On Instagram, I put out a question last week and basically said, you know, I've been saving my shekels and I'm interested in either A, upgrading wheels and tires on the STI, or B, potentially upgrading my camera setup. I told you guys last week or the week, whenever it is, week before, we did a camera setup video and kind of told you what I had and what I was using. The majority of people, well, when I say the majority of people, I mean like the 10 people that responded said that they would prefer to see the wheel and tire setup because I'm assuming, you know, these cameras are quality enough for them for now and they'd rather see the mods to the car than my face in like higher quality HD. But today the tires came in. So I haven't ordered any wheels yet, but the tires are here. Basically I knew what size tire I wanted to run and then it's just, you know, now down to finding the wheel that I want to fit the theme of the car, kind of go with all that stuff. So today we're going to take a look at the tires, talk about kind of where I'm at with wheels, and maybe give you a little bit of information, like if you want to upgrade yours, kind of the process that you go through to figure out what'll fit, what should I consider, you know, etc. Okay, let's take a look. Alright, cool. So here are these are the tires. See, they're Kumos, they're Kumo XZP 91, basically PS 91. This is basically Kumo's brand new tire that's a competitor to the Pilot Super Sports, to the Matt Farah tire that everybody loves. This is the competitor to those. They're supposed to be really good. I've seen pretty good reviews on them so far. Something that is obviously more intriguing about them than the Super Sports is that these are about $75 a tire cheaper than the Super Sports in this size. These are about $150 a tire. And right now there's actually a $75 rebate if you buy four of them. So this is, overall, you'll save a decent amount of money. You'll probably save almost $400 on just tires if you go with this over the Super Sport. I don't know how it compares performance-wise quite yet, but they have little checkered flags on them, which are cool. Which will probably wear off like immediately, but anyway, 265, 35, 18s, as you can see, they are almost identical in overall diameter, height, circumference, whatever. This is like almost as close as you can get to the stock tire size, so shouldn't mess with speedometers or anything. It's definitely wider. Those are 245s, these are 265s. The tread on this is definitely not winter friendly. It's summer only. I have my set of winter tires up there. There's a video on it if you're interested. I run those in the winter so I can run these in the summer. Okay, so when you decide you want to upgrade wheels and tires on whatever car it is, it doesn't have to be an STI, it can be just whatever. You got to take into consideration kind of the offset and diameter and width and all those measurements on the wheel slash tire combination and then your wheel well, etc. If you don't want to worry about any of that sort of information, the last majority of sets of wheels and tires I've bought, I've just gone to a website like Tire Rack or a place that like has done all that measuring and they know with X number of wheels and tire combinations, they for sure will fit your car, and it's usually fairly conservative. If you want to go like super wide or super low offset or whatever, it's not going to let you do that. It's going to keep you in like a safe, conservative, fairly OEM fit wheel and tire combination, but it's super easy because you go on, you pick your car, they show you your car, and you can click and put the wheels on it and change the sizes and just, you know, it's all one-stop shop. You go, pick your wheels, pick your tires, they mount them, they balance them, they ship them to your house, you're good. We didn't do that this time. This time I decided to buy tires and I'm gonna buy wheels separately. I'm gonna have to take them to a shop to get them mounted and balanced and then put them on my car. All of that is very separate steps, but it lets you be a little bit more customizable
a little bit more custom with like the fit and get exactly what you want, as opposed to being limited to whatever website you go to that does the fitment for you. So luckily with cars like WRXs and STIs and whatever, Integra Type Rs and I don't know, every enthusiast car ever made, there's forums that exist that people who've tried fitments, tried wheels, can show you pictures of, this is what it looks like with this low of an offset. Does it rub when I have this suspension versus that suspension? Most of that for most new cars is pretty well documented on the internet. So go there first. Don't ask me in the comment like, hey, I have a 96 Integra. Can I fit 18x9.5-inch wheels on it? Like, probably not, but I don't know. You know, I know for the STI, the fitment I want to go with, but I don't know it for all cars. So there's definitely a forum somewhere to help you with that. That being said, for the STI, I wanted to go with 18x9.5. The stock wheels and tires on the STI are 18x8.5. So we're not going up in diameter of the wheel. We are going up when the width of the wheel. So the diameter is 18 inches. The width of the stock STI is 8.5. We're gonna go to 9.5. That's an inch bigger. What that does, it lets us run a bigger, beefier tire. Some people run the stock tires on the wider rim just to get the wider rim, lower offset kind of look. The other thing is the offset on the stock STI wheels is 55. So 55 is a pretty high offset. The wheel's like fairly sunken into the wheel well. If you get a lower offset, it'll usually push the wheel out towards the edge or past the wheel. You get the poke. Trying to avoid very much poke. The flush sort of life is more what I'm interested in. Initially, I'm not planning to do a whole lot of suspension work, so eventually we'll probably maybe do like a little drop or whatever. I'm gonna get the wheels and tires on, see what fits, see how it looks, and then go from there. But they're 265, 35, 18s. The stock tire is a 245, so it's, you know, 20 millimeters wider or whatever. It's a decent amount wider. It's a decent amount beefier rubber. It's pretty well documented. That's kind of the biggest tire you can go with on STIs and WRXs without having to do a whole lot of suspension work and clearancing in the fender wells. So with the right offset, you can run that in a stock setup and not rub, which is where we get into the what wheels do you choose, because they have to have the right offset to be able to run that. A lot of people run 255s, which is just a bump up from the 245. So a lot of information, a lot of forums you got to go and look through and just digest to figure out what's the fitment that you want to go with. That being said, it's very hard. It's like a lot of time and effort and energy to go look on the internet and figure out what you're looking for. So if you just want the easy route, go Tire Rack or some one of those websites and just pick a wheel and tire thing that you like and get it done. Cool, so those are the tires. I need your guys' help. I want you to kind of throw out some other wheel options if you have them. I have a set in my mind that I'm pretty sure I'm gonna buy, but I'm just kind of like toying with what other options do I have. Are there some that are cheaper in the same ballpark? I don't want to go $3,000 wheels, $2,000 wheels. Like, once you get into like the super high-end wheels, I daily drive the car. Sometimes I park in areas that are not the greatest, so I don't need $800 per wheel sitting on the car getting ready to slay some daily driving. So keep in mind, I'm trying to keep it fairly budget, under $300 or under per wheel. But if you have other suggestions, it's got to fit a 265x18 tire, and it has to be able to fit without being too pokey. So 38 to 45, I think that's kind of the general offset that'll accomplish that. So send me wheel suggestions if you have them. I have a box in the garage right now that has a Forester mod. Well, I don't know if it's a mod. It's more like an accessory that's gonna lead to a mod for the Forester. On top of that, I have a vendor actually that's working with me to send me some cool stuff to try out for both the STI as well as the Forester XT. Got some cool stuff coming up, cool like little tests. We're gonna figure out if this stuff is cool and worthwhile, and maybe you guys can buy it. But yeah, it's cool, it's exciting, the channel's growing. We're almost to 5,000 subscribers, which is ridiculous, and I really appreciate all you guys. I promise you, we hit 5K, I'm doing a Taco Bell run, and I'm gonna eat like the entire menu. Maybe not literally, but I'm gonna slay some Taco Bell because we're hitting the 5K. I really appreciate all the new subscribers, Forester people, BMW people, STI people, all of you. You're welcome here. I love you. And I hope you stick around. Hope you're enjoying the videos. Small nugget. I've seen a lot of people texting and driving on my way to work lately. It's not cool. Put the phones down. make driving the priority, make the safety of yourself and others around you the priority. You're driving a giant metal object at like 60 miles an hour that can just destroy everyone. So anyway, I know you guys aren't about that life, but keep that in mind. Tell your friends, don't text and drive, don't drink and drive, be safe. And I really appreciate you guys watching. Should have the wheels soon. I might actually go buy some tomorrow if I don't get any cool suggestions. And yeah, that's all I got. Make driving the priority. Love you guys. See you later. Bye-bye.